Hello students, in this video we are going to see what is an optimal binary search tree. Before going for a optimal binary search tree, we should know what is a binary search tree. A binary search tree is nothing but an important data structure in which you can perform the operations like searching, insertion and deletion. An optimal binary search tree is the one in which we are going to find an optimal tree which is having the lowest number of comparisons. For example, if we take four keys A, B, C and D with the searching probabilities of 0.1, 0.2, 0.4 and 0.3 respectively, we can construct a many number of trees with these four keys. These are the two sample trees. If you take the number of comparisons needed for the successful search of A, B, C and D, that will be 2.9, because here the probability of occurrence of A is 0.1 into the number of comparisons needed for the successful search of A is 1. In the case of B, the number of comparisons needed is 2. In the case of C, the number of comparisons needed is 3. Because first you have to compare with A. Since C is greater than A, you have to move to the right side. Since C is greater than B, you have to move to the right side. Here you are going to check whether it is equal. It will become equal. That is, you have to make comparison here. Here first, that is 1. Here you have to make the second comparison. Here you have to make the third comparison. So for C, the probability of its occurrence into the number of comparisons needed. Likewise, the total number, the average number of comparisons for this successful search of these four elements A, B, C and D is equal to 2.9. For this tree, it will be, see here, for A, there are two comparisons needed, okay? The probability of occurrence into 2. For B, there is only one comparison needed, 0.2 into 1. Likewise, you have to calculate the number of comparisons needed. If you find what is the average number of comparisons, it is 2.1 here. You cannot tell, comparing these two, this may be an optimal binary search tree, but it is not an optimal binary search tree comparing to the 14 possible comparisons. Okay, 14 possible trees that you can make with these four keys. Okay, the number of binary search trees that can be formed with n keys is called as a Catalan number. That can be given as C of n is equal to 1 by n plus 1 into 2n Cn. For n is the number of keys by which using which you are going to perform the you are going to form the binary search trees. Suppose if a1 and a up to an are the different keys using which you are going to perform the you are going to form a binary search tree, and p1 up to pn is the probability of searching for them. Okay, now here C of I comma j be the smallest average number of comparisons we are going to frame. Okay, and then you are going to construct a tree Tij. Okay, now we can write as here C of I comma j is equal to minimum of, because we are going to find a tree which is having the minimum number of comparisons. Suppose pk, that is the k is the node which is going to form as the root, then the average number of comparisons needed is 1. In the case of the other trees which is lesser than k, that is for I is equal to k s is equal to I to k minus 1, that is the probability of their occurrence into their level. And then here if k becomes the root and all the other nodes, that is to the right of k, that is k plus 1 to j. I to j is the total number of nodes, that is 1 to n, okay, ps into level of as in the given tree. Okay, if you simplify it, you'll come across this recurrence relation. So the recurrence relation can be written as C of I comma j is equal to minimum of I to, that is k lies between I and j, C of I comma k minus 1 plus C of k plus 1 comma j, and this is the probability of further for all the probabilities you are going to summarize. Okay, now if you take this the initial conditions for this recurrence relation is C of I comma I minus 1, that is it represents an empty tree, there is no comparisons are needed, so it will be equal to 0. I comma I, that is if it is an one node tree, that you need for only one comparison, the probability of occurrence is pi, so pi into 1 is pi. Okay, so the initial conditions are C I comma I minus 1 is equal to 0, and the other one is C of I comma I is equal to pi. Now we are going to compute C of 1 comma n, that is I comma j, instead of I comma j, I am going to perform compute C of 1 comma n. In this case, we are going to take another two-dimensional table to record the values of k for which this C of I comma j is minimum. We'll see an example Here there are four keys. That is the occurrence of this keys, the probability of occurrence of these keys are given. Now we are going to construct a optimal binary search tree using this dynamic programming approach. Okay, initially the table will look like this. Since there are four keys, I'm going to have 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Okay, and then here I plus, there is up to k plus 1 you have to have. Okay, that is, there are 4 keys, so 4 plus 1 5. Okay, the initial condition is c of I comma I minus 1 is equal to 0. That is, for 1 comma 0 it should be 0, 2 comma 1 it should be 0, 3 comma 2 it should be 0. Likewise you have to fill. Okay, next one, c of I comma I is equal to the probability of occurrence. That is, 1 comma 1 is the probability of occurrence that is given in the table 0.1, 2 comma 2 this one, 3 comma 3 this one, 4 comma 4 this one. Okay, now here this is table is the another table that you are going to maintain for this in order to record the value of k, for which the value is c of I comma j is minimum. Okay, here when you consider this a one, that is a 1 comma 1, that means you are having only one node, that is the for, that is a, that is one means here it is a, that is having a is the key. If a is the node by which only one node that is present, the tree going to frame will be having only one node, that is A. So for A, the root of A is A. So for in the root table, 1 comma 1 is 1, similarly 2 comma 2 is 2, 3 comma 3 is 3, 4 comma 4 is 4. That is, you are filling this table, this root table, by considering if represents, that is here the root for 1, if the only one node present is 1. Okay, here now we have filled the initial table. So this is for filling the values of c of I comma j, this is for filling the values of k for which this c of I comma j is minimum. Okay, now first we have to find now 1 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 3 comma 4 first you have to find. Okay, so for finding c of 1 comma 2, it is minimum of, based on this equation, minimum of c of I comma k minus 1, c of k plus 1 comma j. For this you have to find the minimum plus, that is this probability value. Okay, now here c of 1 comma 2 for which k is equal to, k lies between I and j, so k will be having the value 1 comma 2, and c of I comma k minus 1, I value is 1, k minus 1 is 1 minus 1 0, plus c of k plus 1, k plus 1 is 1 plus 1 2 comma j, j value is 2. Okay, and then you have to find for that you have to add this probability of all the values. Okay, this 1 comma 0 can be got from this table. 1 comma 0 is 0. Okay, 1 comma 0 is 0, 2 comma 2 is 0.2, and then this sum of the probabilities of 1 and 2, that is the sum of the probabilities of 1 and 2 is 0.1 plus 0.2 is 0.3. Okay, 0.3. Okay, you have to find this sum, and then for k is equal to 2, you have to find this sum. C of 1 comma 1 is 1 comma 1 is 0.1, so 0.1. Next, C of 3 comma 2, so 3, C of 3 comma 2 is 0. 0 plus the probability of PS, okay, for probability of occurrence of first node as well as the second node, that is 0.1 plus 0.2, that is 0.3. If you sum it up, you will get 0.0 plus 0.2 plus 0.3 is 0.5. Here 0.1 plus 0 plus 0.3 is 0.4. Okay, the minimum of 0.5 and 0.4 is 0.4. Okay, so you have to make this entry into this first table. C of 1 comma 2 is 0.4. See here, C of 1 comma 2 is, I have to put 0.4. See here, C of 1 comma 2 is 0.4, and this 0.4 I got for the value of k. Is it on, for the value of k is equal to 2, is it or not? Here this first set of values, for that is, for k is equal to 1, you are getting 0.5, for k is equal to 2 you are getting 0.4, the minimum is 0.4. so for what value of k you are getting c of 1 comma 2 is minimum is for k is equal to 2. Okay, so you have to make this entry here, 1 comma 2, you have to make this entry 2, and the value you are getting is, you have to note it there. Okay, next you have to find what is CF 2,3. For 2,3, by applying the formula, you are getting 1.0 and 0.8. The minimum value is 0.8 and the CF 2,3 is 0.8. And this 0.8 is got for K is equal to 3. Okay. So, CF 2,3 is 0.8 and CF 2,3 in the case of root table, you have to put 3 because for K value is equal to 3, you are getting this 0.8 as the minimum. Likewise, you have to calculate for CF 3.3,4 and you have to make this entry here, 3,4, this entry here, and the corresponding root table you have to map, you have to fill this. So this is the position of the tables after finding these three values, that is CF 1,2, 2,3 and 3,4. Next, what you have to find is, you have to find what is 1,3 and 2,4. 1,3, for finding 1,3 and 2,4, the K value ranges from 1, 2 and 3. By applying the same formula, you have to find the sum of, for K is equal to what is the value of this equation and for K is equal to what is the value of this equation. For K is equal to 3, what is the value of this equation? These entries has to be, you have to get from the previous table, that is from this table, okay? You have to find, and then you have to find what is the minimum value. For 1,3, I'm getting the minimum value to be 1.1. This 1.1 I got for K is equal to 3, okay? So, see 1,3 is 1.1 for K is equal to 3. Here, see here, see 1,3 is 1.1 for, and this in the root table, you have to put the K value 1,3, you have to put this K value 3. For see the next example, that is the next one, CF 2,4. Here the minimum value is 1.4. This minimum value 1.4 for I got for K is equal to 3. So 2,4 is 1.4. The minimum value is for K is equal to 3, you are getting this. So 2,4 you have to put 3. Okay. Now we have filled this table. Using this table, next we have to find this value of 1,4 in this CFIJ table as well as in this root table. For this, the K value ranges from 1 to 4. When you apply the formula, you will get this minimum value to be 1.7. This 1.7 I got for K is equal to 3. Okay. So after finding this, you have to fill the entry in this table 1.7. So I'm getting the this value for K is equal to 3. So in the root table, I have to enter 1 for 1,4 to be 3. Now we have filled the table, both the CFIJ as well as the root table. See here, the table is half full. Another half, you need not fill it. Okay. Now we have found that the average number of comparisons in the, when you construct an optimal tree will be 1.7. Here now we have to next construct the tree. So this is my average number of comparisons. This is I got for 1,4. When you see this 1,4 in the root table, you get 3. The third key for our in our example is C. So C should be my root. If C is the root, then A,B should be in the left of C and D should be in the right of C. That we know because it is a binary search tree. Okay. Now we have to find where is A and where is B. See, C should be here and A and B should be in the left of C and D should be in the right of D. This thing we can easily fill up. Okay. Next, we have to see how this A and B should be filled. Okay. For if you see the root table for A and B, 1,2. If you see the root table, 1,2, that is for key A and key B. For the first key and the second key, that is A and B, the root should be 2. That means B should be the root. Okay. If B should be the root, B becomes the root, ultimately the A will become the child. So this is my optimal binary search tree for which the search, the average search value will be minimum. Thank you.